हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम टी उपेंद्रैया, स्कूल असिस्टेंट मैथ्स, ZBHS, सिरिपुरम केजी, वैरा मंडलम, खम्मम डिस्ट्रिक्ट. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द स्टैटिस्टिक्स, नथिंग बट डेटा हैंडलिंग ऑफ योर नाइन्थ क्लास. सो स्टैटिक्स statistics was introduced by Sir Ronald A. Fisher. That is why he is called father of statistics. In our previous classes, this topic was already discussed with the name of data handling. In our day-to-day life, we come across different datas. Suppose if you go to a hotel, there is a list of prices of different items. And if you go to a kirana shop, there is also, you see, a list of prices. So that is why that table gives you some information. So the statistics is nothing but data handling. It is all about data. So this data is very important for statistics. So that is why in our country, for every 10 years, the statistical department is taking census, isn't it? Maybe 2021, we are going to collect all the information about the people who are living in India, so that by taking that information, what we have to do? Why we have to learn statistics? Why? Because based on that data, we are going to plan how much schools are there, how many schools are going to be opened, how much amount of paddy. And so many our betterment, the government should plan. For the planning of developmental programs and allocation of resources, the data is required. So that is why, so here, the first of all, the statistics is based on the data. So to get success, we must have a plan. So all the plans must be based on the data available. So that is why statistics is all about data. So first, let us learn what is data. So data is nothing but the facts. The facts are figures. The facts are figures which are numerical, otherwise collected with a definite purpose are called data. Okay, what is data? The facts or figures which may be numerical or otherwise, which are collected with a definite purpose, are called data. So here, the collection of data. Next, collection of data is of two types. That is, the first one, primary data, and the second, secondary data. Okay, the collection of data. We can collect the data in two ways, that is the primary data and the secondary data. So now let us discuss what is primary data. What is primary data? The first one, primary data. So what is primary data? The information collected by an investigator directly by inquiring is called the primary data. So what is primary data? The information collected by the investigator with a definite objective directly by inquiring . So here the investigator must approach to the individual to collect the data. So such information collected by the investigator is primary data. For example, for this one, heights of 15 plants in your school ground. And number of siblings that each student have and the distance between school and the residence of your classmates. Okay, so these are the examples for primary data. What is primary data? The information collected by the investigator with a definite objective directly by inquiring. So these are the examples. Suppose if you want to find the heights of 15 plants in your school ground or garden, you have to go to each and every plant. You have to take the height of the plant. So that is why this is, you are collecting the data directly by you, that is the investigator. That is why it is called primary data. And number of siblings that each student have that in your class, it is also primary data. And the distance between school and the residence of your classmates is totally different. That is why you have to collect by approaching each student. So that is why this is called the primary data. So now the second one is the secondary data. Secondary data. So what is the secondary data? The information collected by the investigator with a definite objective directly? No, this is indirectly. Here, the new word indirectly, 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 so here the secondary data is nothing but the information collected by the investigator with a definite objective indirectly, that is from any other source, any other other source. What is the other source? Which had already been recorded, say as registers. So here in the primary data, the investigator collected the data directly by inquiring each and every one. But here in the secondary data, the information collected by the investigator with a definite objective indirectly, that is from any other source. How we are going to get this other source, which had already been recorded, say as registers or records. So here example for the secondary data is the collection of students who enrolled in your school during 2015 to 2019. And second one, the collection of data of farmers who got Raitu Bandhu. In 2018, and 2019. So you may not go to each and every farmer to collect this data. It is a very hard task. That is why just you go to the agricultural extensional officer and you can collect the data of the farmers who got Rait Bandhu in the years 2018 and 2019. Isn't it? In the same way, the collection of students who enrolled in our school during 2015 to 2019, this information is recorded as the registers or records. That is why you can collect that data indirectly. You may not go to each and every student who is joined in 2015 and 2000 between these 2 years. So that is why the mode of collecting the data in this way, that is indirectly, that is from any other source which had already been recorded as registers and records, such type of data is called secondary data. Suppose if you want to select a best cricket man, how you are going to select based on the data of that particular batsman and which was recorded as earlier? With that information you are going to take a decision. That is why the data is collected in two ways, that is the first one is primary data and the second one is the secondary data. Okay, so now Now the data is of two forms. That is, the first one is raw data. Raw data, and the second one is grouped data. Grouped data. This raw data is also called as ungrouped data. Ungrouped data. Sometimes this is unclassified. Unclassified data. And this grouped data is sometimes called classified. Classified data. Okay. Actually, the data is nothing but the facts or the figures which are either in numerical or otherwise collected with a definite purpose is called data. This data may be in two forms, that is raw data. Just we are collected the data with the numerical facts, that is raw data. If this raw data can be converted in another form, that is group data. So let us discuss the first one, that is the raw data. Okay, what is raw data? First one is the first one, this is second one. The first one, raw data. What is raw data? If the data is just in the form of, if the data is just in the form of, in the form of facts or numerals, then it is raw data. Got the point? What is raw data? Just it is nothing but in the form of facts or numerals. For example, so here I am writing some numbers 0, 2, 7, 3, 5, 8, 9, 10, 1, and 4. Suppose these are the marks of 10 student for 10 marks. So these are the numerals. And suppose some facts, the blood groups, suppose A, B, O, the O negative, this is O positive, and AB, some O plus, B, and A, O negative, and B. So these are the blood groups of 10 persons or 10 students in our class, and this is raw data. Okay, the raw data is the information just in the form of facts or numerals, then it is called raw data. This does not gives any idea, and this if you have knowledge about the blood groups, then you can identify, yes, these are the blood groups. But here you can say just these are the numbers. Unless I told to you what are these, firstly I said that these are the marks got by 10 students for 10 marks. That is why the first person got 0 marks, and second one 2, third one 7 marks, and fourth one 3 marks, like this. So this is the raw data. So this does not give any idea. That is why after collecting the data, we must plan to represent in the form which is meaningful and easy to understand and shows the salient features at a glance. That is why presentation of raw data is also very important. So next topic is presentation of raw data. presentation of raw data. What is that? Presentation of raw data. How we are going to present the raw data? Once the data is collected, the investigator has to find out ways to present in the form which is the data must be present in the form of which is in the form of meaningful. Second one, easy to understand and shows the main features at a glance. Okay, so the raw data, after collecting the raw data, the investigator has to find out the ways how to present the data, so which is meaningful and easy to understand, and that shows the main features at a glance. So that is why the raw data can be represented in two ways. That is, the raw data has been arranged either in ascending order or descending order and in alphabetical order also. Alphabetical order to make it easier. Why we have to arrange this? To make it easier to handle. Okay, the first one. Suppose if I gave the raw data like this. These are the marks secured by 11 members. A test was conducted for 50 marks. So these are the marks, that is 25, 34 and 42, 50, 30, 11, 43, 45, 7, 20 and 39. Observe that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yes. So this is the raw data. What are these? These are the marks obtained by 11 students for a test conducted for 50 marks. Okay. This does not give us any information actually. So that is why what we have to do. So here the presentation of raw data is, once the data is collected, the investigator has to find out the ways to present in the form which is meaningful, which must be easy to understand, and it shows the main features at a glance. So that is why if the raw data is given like this, this may be arranged in one of these forms. So what are the first, this raw data can be arranged in ascending order, that is AO, ascending order. Ascending order is the small to big. What is the small number here? The 7. Okay, 7 after is 11. 11 after 20. And next one 25. And the next one 30. And next 34. And the next one 39. 42. And next one 45. And 50. Okay, 11 observations. Here, 11 observations are here. Okay. From this ascending order, can we make it sensible? Yes, definitely. So here we can find the minimum value. What is the minimum value? And we can find the maximum value. Maximum value. So what is the minimum value here? The minimum value is the first one 7, and the maximum is 50. With this, we can find range, the another concept, range of raw data. Raw data is equal to maximum value. Maximum value minus minimum value. Maximum value minus minimum value is the range of the data. So here, what is the range of this data? That is equal to 50 minus 7, that is equal to 43, is the range of this data. And we can find the middlemost term, middlemost observation, middlemost term in this data is, so here there are 11 observations, therefore we get this one here, this side 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 observations, and right side 5 observations. We get only one observation as middlemost term, that is 34. So from this, by arranging the data either in ascending order or descending order, it must be some sensible. That is, we can find the minimum value by looking at this, and we can find the maximum value. We can find the range of the data. What is the formula for range of the data? Remember this one. Maximum value minus minimum value is called range of the data. So middlemost term. So we can find likewise the required items. Suppose when the number of observations are too many, is this convenient way to represent either in ascending order or descending order? It takes a lot of time. It is time consuming process. That is why we must try to select another way to represent this raw data. Okay, so that is the second way of representing raw data. So the second one is, when the number of observations in a data, when the number of observations in the data are too many, presenting it, then presenting it in ascending order or descending order is time consuming. Therefore, we must think of an alternative method that is the data is tabulated. The data is tabulated using tally marks. Do you know what is tally mark? In your previous classes, we discussed tally mark. Tally mark is a method to represent the frequency of an observation in the data. For example, for three, we draw three vertical lines. This is okay. The tally mark is generally denoted by this vertical line. This is the symbol for tally mark. Okay. Is the vertical line. So for 3 we draw 3 vertical lines, for 4 we draw 4 vertical lines, for 5 we draw like this 4 vertical lines, and another slant line must be marked across these 4 vertical lines. Okay. For the fifth frequency, here for every fifth frequency, for every fifth frequency, a slant line is marked across the 4 vertical lines. Okay, remember or recall this one. In 8th class we have done. So what is the second way to represent the raw data? So here, when the number of observations in the data are too many, then the presenting it in either ascending order or descending order is time consuming. Therefore, we must think of an alternative method, that is, it must be tabulated using tally marks. Here, this is the tally mark, and the tally mark is a method to represent the frequency of an observation in the data. For 3, we have to draw 3 vertical lines, and like this, we have to draw. So, let us take one example, how to represent this ungrouped data through tally marks. Okay. So here one more thing, frequency. Okay, frequency. What is frequency? This is also to be known fact. That is, the frequency is nothing but the number of times that an observation occurs in the data is called the frequency. So let us represent the raw data which contains too many observations with this form. Okay, so here suppose if we take the raw data like this, I am taking the raw data, that is the consider the marks obtained by 30 students. These are marks obtained by 30 students for 10 marks. These are just small information. This the raw data is like this. 1. The first person got 1 mark. 1 and 3, 4, 5, 8, 6, 7, 10, 2, and 1, 1, 3, 4, 4, 5, 8, 6, 7, 10, and 2, 8, 6, 4, 2, 5, 4, 9, and 10, 4. Okay? So, this is the raw data. So, here what we have to do? We can find the range also. Here the smallest mark is 1 and the biggest is 10. We have to represent this data using the tally marks. How we are going to represent this? Here we have to write the marks like this. And here tally marks. Tally marks. And here number of students. Number of students. Nothing but frequency. It's nothing but frequency. So here how many marks are here from 1 to 100? 1 to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Okay. Here we are going to write the tally marks. First you start from this 1. Here we have 1 tally mark. Here 1. Here 3. Just you have to write like 4, you have to write 4 and 5, 8 and now 6, 7, 10, the last one and 2. The first row completed, next one. Next, once again we got 1, here 3, here 4, and once again 4, and here we get 5, and 8, and 6, here 6, 7, and 10. We have finished the second row. And now second, that is 2, and 8, and here 6, 4, 2, 5, 4, we have 4, and 9, here we have 9, and 10, that is the last one is 4 once again. So these are the tally marks. We have to write the number of students by counting the tally marks. The frequency of 1 is how much? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4. And here the frequency of 2 is 3. And here the frequency of 3 is 2. And frequency of 4 is, this is 5 plus 1, that is 6. And here 5, 3. And here 6, this is also 3. 7 we have 2. And 8, 3, and 9, only 1, and 10, 3. So that the total is 30. So we are taking the marks obtained by 30 students for 10 marks. So the way of representation, the observations with frequency is called ungrouped frequency distribution table or table of weighted observation. Okay? So what is that? The way of, just write down, the way of representing the data with frequency is called ungrouped frequency distribution table, or table of weighted observations. Here all the observations are represented with frequency using tally marks is known as ungrouped frequency distribution table. So if the raw data is given, to make it more meaningful, we have to convert this raw data as a tabulated manner. So that is, for this we use tally marks to represent the frequency of particular observation. Suppose if you want to know the frequency of 4, here is 6. You have to write like this. Okay. So in your textbook, in the exercise 14.1, the first exercise, you have problems like this. You try to complete the ungrouped frequency distribution tables. In the next class, we are going to discuss about the grouped data. Okay? See you.